Here's a scary fact. Over 30,000 websites are hacked every single day. And 43% of those websites are targeted at small businesses. Do you want your website to be part of that 30,000 that get hacked every single day? I'm assuming not. Well, if not, then you've come to the right video. Because in this video, I'm going to give you amazing security tips that will harden your website's security. And the best part is, all of these are easy to implement. So all you have to do is watch the video till the end and implement those tips I'm going to give you. So let's begin. The first tip you should keep in mind with regards to WordPress security is always keep your WordPress versions up to date. For example, I'm here inside my website, I'm checking out the posts, I want to add new posts. Everything that you do, if a new version of WordPress is available, you'll see a notice right here. You can see it right here. And if you don't see it, let's say you have a minor version update coming, then you can just go to the dashboard settings and go to updates here and you'll see a notice. And you can also manually check, or I say force check, if a new version of WordPress is available. So you see my current version 6.4.1, you'll see a button here where it'll show you, hey, check for updates. So whenever there's an update, usually what you should do is, the first thing you should do is back up your website and then update to the latest version. This will ensure that you have the latest features, the best performance, and most importantly, the best security that WordPress has to offer. So go to your website right now, or maybe after watching this video, and check if you have any pending updates and update to the latest version. The next thing to remember when it comes to WordPress security is to pay attention to the hosting provider. Now, you might not consider hosting as an essential part of your WordPress security, but it's absolutely critical to have the right hosting provider. Otherwise, the security of your website might be compromised. Now, there are hundreds of things to discuss in this, but the easiest way I can tell you to how to make sure that your WordPress host that you're choosing is secure is to go for a hosting provider that has high reputation. For small and medium websites, we recommend that you go for SiteGround, Hostinger, or Bluehost. All of them have great pricing plans, great solutions, great offerings, and you most of the time will also get a domain name for free if you use our referral link, which will be linked down below in the description of this video. Apart from this, if you have plans of making a very big website or you're looking for managed hosting solutions, then we recommend WP Engine. Now, the essential idea is pick a hosting provider that has a great reputation in the market and is known for its good customer service and security features. Once again, if you're just starting out, want to build a small business website or just a personal website, go for Bluehost, Hostinger, or SiteGround, any of these options. I'll place links on the screen. Links are also in the description. Go check them out. They have fantastic offers, fantastic pricing. I'll see you in the next one. The next security tip to keep in mind is to always, always create backups of your website. Now, backing up your website is like having an insurance policy. It won't prevent your website from being hacked, but as you might have realized already, nothing is 100% secure anyway. Protected government agencies, big social media networks, everything can be hacked. So if the case arises, your website might be hacked, at least you will have backups to restore your website and you can get back your control of your website using the backups. Now, there are many solutions out there. Your hosting provider might also provide backup solutions, but we recommend using a dedicated plugin for backups. There are a few advantages of this. The first advantage being more control over when you backup, how you backup, how frequently you backup, and off-site backups. That means backups that are not present on your server. So by chance, if your server gets hacked or the hosting provider itself gets hacked, you will still have backups available elsewhere. So if the case arises, you can't have access or the hosting company is completely compromised, you can at least take your website to another hosting provider and start your website there. So this is why having a dedicated plugin, having off-site backups are important. Now, there are many plugins available in the market who offer this service, but our vote goes to Duplicator. It's a fantastic plugin. This is a quick demonstration of how Duplicator works, how it looks like. You can create scheduled backups. You can go into this, create manual backups, create extensive schedules, what's backup, how it's backup. And I've done a complete video on showing how Duplicator works and how you can create backups with it. So I'll show it on the screen here. And I'll also link that video in the description of this video, so you can go check it out after you watch this video and figure out if Duplicator is the right plugin for you. Regardless of if you choose Duplicator to backup your website, always have backups, always have offsite backups. So if anything goes wrong, you'll have peace of mind that you can get back or get your website up as quickly as possible, regardless of the solution, regardless of the current situation your website is in. All right, on to the next one. The next security tip to keep in mind is to install a security plugin. Now, security plugin acts like an antivirus, but for your website. Similar to how antiviruses protect your computer from getting hacked, so they'll block all vulnerabilities, a security plugin on your website does the same thing. It'll find out all the vulnerabilities that you have and notify you. It'll also notify and check if you have any kind of infections on your website existing on any of your files. And if any plugin or any service external request tries to change the WordPress files, it'll also protect against this. So anything that happens on your website, which has the potential of getting your website hacked, a security plugin will protect you against that. And our recommendation or the best plugin that we found that we also use on our website is Sucre, which is a fantastic security solution for WordPress. This is a free plugin on WordPress, so you can start using the service for free. And the free version is great or good enough for most websites. They also have a premium offering with more services, more better solutions, and it's absolutely worth it. If you have a business critical website, just check out the premium version and definitely upgrade to it. So it'll provide you tons of features. You'll have security activity, you'll have file integrity monitoring, you'll have remote malware scanning, you'll have blocklist monitoring and security hardening, post hack security actions, and tons of features even in the free version. It's a fantastic solution. Definitely check out Sucre and just install it on your website. You'll be thanking me later. The next security tip you should follow is also use a web application firewall. Now, what's the difference between a web application firewall and a security plugin? A web application firewall acts like a firewall. So before the requests come to your site, any kind of malicious activity that can be detected and prevented, a web application firewall is responsible for that. Similar to how your computers also have firewalls that filter requests coming to your computer in the first place, a web application firewall protects your website the same way. Now, there are many solutions out there that provide the web application firewall functionality that I just mentioned, but the best one on the market is Cloudflare. Now, with Cloudflare, Sucre, which I was mentioning in the previous point, also offers a web application firewall that you can configure right on WordPress. So it's your choice if you want to go to Cloudflare or you want to use Sucre. Now, to make the decision-making process easier, you can choose anyone, but if you want to go into the depths and details of what the differences are, what the pros and cons are, we have a detailed article on our website which does the comparison for you. So I'll link that in the description of this video. You can go check it out, read it, and figure out which of these solutions is the best one for you. So make sure to have a security plugin, which is Sucre, and then choose what web application firewall would you like to choose, Sucre or Cloudflare, and let me know in the comments which one do you choose. The next security tip to keep in mind is to always use an SSL or move to the HTTPS version of your website. This offers two advantages. The HTTPS version is obviously more secure. That means the data of your customers and the data of your website will be more secure. And the HTTP version provides a very bad experience, especially in Google Chrome. Let me give you an example. This is a sample website that I've created for use. Now, look at this. What do you see here? Not secure. Why does Google say this? Because I'm not using HTTPS on your website. So if you're creating a website and you don't have HTTPS or SSL not installed, every time any visitor comes to your site, they'll see this. Now think of this. Is this confidence inspiring? No. Will users edit their credit card info here? No. Will users trust this information? Maybe no. That's why using an SSL and moving to the HTTPS version is absolutely critical for new websites. Now, thankfully, if you have a new website or you're just planning to create a website, you don't have to do anything. If you just go to the link in the description, let's say you build a website with Bluehost or Hostinger, they'll provide you an SSL certificate code completely free. You'll not need to configure it. It'll be added to your account automatically. And by default, when you just add your domain name to your account, it'll automatically be created with HTTPS. So you won't have to do anything unless you have an old website which was built with HTTP. In that case, I'll link a couple of tutorials down in the description on how to move from HTTP to HTTPS and then secure your website and have a better impression on your visitors. The next security tip I have to offer you is to always change the default username something from admin. For example, this is a typical website and most users, when they're starting out, they would keep a very simple username like admin. Now, most hackers realize this and they try to get your website by guessing your password. So what you should do is change this to something more secure. Use something that cannot be easily guessed. Here's how to do it. Go into add users in the website, go to the dashboard, users, add new user, create a new user. So enter username, enter the email, you can use the same email, everything else, and just make it an administrator on the website. So instead of using the real role as subscriber, just go and choose the administrator. So this user will now also become the administrator, and then you can delete the old user with the admin username. On the same topic, I have another tip. Make sure to use secure and I say complicated passwords. Now they are hard to remember, but you have to have this. Use a security or a password manager if you have to, like 1Password or LastPass, but it's absolutely critical that you have good passwords. And WordPress does a great job of suggesting very secure passwords, which you can see on the screen here. So you can also use this kind of password, just add your LastPass or 1Pass account, and it'll immediately be saved inside the account and you won't have to remember it. So two things that I just told you, change the default admin username to something else and also use a secure password. The next security feature you should be aware of and you should enable on your website is disable file editing options. Let me explain. So this is the built-in file editor inside WordPress. You can check all of your theme files are available here and you can manipulate them right here. Now it's a great feature for developers, but not so for common people who don't understand what they're doing. Now by accident, somebody can modify this and any administrator you have on your site has access to this. So they can intentionally or unintentionally mess up your website. This is a good idea to disable this functionality altogether because there are other ways to manage and modify code snippets if you need to. So what I would suggest is you take this piece of code, which I'm going to place on the screen, take a screenshot to just make a note of it somewhere and add it to your WP config file. Now, if you don't want to do that and you might be thinking, Yuvraj, you're telling us how to disable file editing and you want us to edit files in the first place. I understand the irony of that statement. So what you can do is the plugin I mentioned in my previous example or previous point, Sucre plugin has a built-in feature for this. Just go into that feature, enable it, and you'll automatically disable all the file editing options inside WordPress. So that's the tip for you. The next security implementation you should do on your website is disable PHP execution in certain directories. Now let me explain what this means. PHP or PHP is the building block of WordPress, and PHP files are executed whenever any kind of plugin is used or any kind of, let's say, page is loaded. There are certain directories where there's no requirement for PHP files to exist and execute. For example, your uploads directory where only the media exists. So it's a good idea to prevent any PHP from executing in those directories in the first place. Now, regardless of if you understood my explanation or not, all you have to do to make it happen is take this piece of code, which I'm going to highlight on the screen, and I'm going to keep it there so that you can take a screenshot or use it as a reference. Just add it to your htaccess file. Now, if you don't know what htaccess is, you don't want to mess with files, no worries. You don't have to do this if you don't want to do it this way. The plugin I mentioned already, Sucre, already has this feature. As I mentioned in my previous example, well, if you want to disable file editing feature, just use the hardening feature. Similar to that, or I'd say exactly like that, just enable the hardening feature inside Sucre. And what happens is, Sucre will automatically disable this from happening, making your website more secure. The next security feature you should implement on your website is to limit the number of login attempts. Now think about this. If you try your password a couple of times, three times, and you've forgotten it, you'll just reset it, right? You won't try to log in 10, 20, 30 times. That's kind of behavior that you expect from somebody trying to gain unauthorized access to your website. So to essentially prevent them, just limit the number of attempts you give anyone to log into your site and then log them out. So how do you implement this feature on your website? There are two different ways. First of all, if you're a premium Sucre user, then the security access firewall in Sucre already will have this feature. They'll automatically detect if somebody's trying to do this and lock them out. You can see this description here. So if after watching this video, you decide that Sucre Premium is for you, then you'll have this feature already. Otherwise, there's another plugin that you can use to do this. It's called Login Lockdown. You don't have to pay for this plugin. It's completely free. It has some premium features as well. But in the free version, you'll be able to just install it, go to settings, and limit the number of attempts that you give someone before you lock them out. While there's no hard and fast rule, I'd say a limit of 5 login attempts is generous, where anybody not remembering the password after 5 attempts should either be forced to reset their password or be completely locked out of logging into your website. So make sure to use this plugin and also use Sucre if you have the premium version and secure your website. The next thing to implement on your website is enable two-factor authentication. Now, what is two-factor authentication? Your password is one-factor authentication. There's one factor required before anybody can log into your website. If they have your password, they can log in. Two-factor authentication multiplies the security by multifold by enabling a second-factor authentication. Usually, it's a one-time password delivered through an SMS or a lazy lesson app. And sometimes, it's an authentication code that can only be accessed with Google Authenticator or Authy. Now, setting this up is out of the scope of this video, but what you can do is use the same plugin called WP Login Lockdown, use the premium version of the plugin and use the two-factor authentication feature here. Once you set it up, you'll have an app on your phone which will give you a code every 30 seconds or 60 seconds which you'll have to enter your website after you enter your password. So anybody even gets your password, they won't be able to log into your website without having that code, and that's how it makes it more secure. Now, WP Login Lockdown is not the only plugin that does this. There are 100 plugins probably out there, but this is a plugin we recommend, so you can use this. If you have any other plugin choices in mind and you have already seen some other plugins offering this and you find them more competitive or better to suit it to your needs, go ahead. But the bottom line is that you should have two-factor authentication enabled on your site if you want to secure it. The next thing to implement on your website to harden its security is change the database prefix. Whenever WordPress creates new tables or even uses a database, it has a prefix to the name of the table, which is usually WP underscore. Now, in alone, this is not enough for somebody to hack your website, but it's like somebody knowing the first four digits of your social security number. Not ideal in any case. Unlike your social security number, you can actually change the prefix to make it harder for anybody to discover information about your website, which can then lead to your website being hacked. Now, fair bit of warning, changing the prefix of your database tables and your database is not for the faint-hearted. It is a little bit of a technical process. So only continue on and only do this if you think you can pull it off and you have some level of reasonable skills. If you think you can do that, then this is a blog post you should follow. It's a step-by-step process on how to change this. It's also an accompanying video. I'll link the entire article in the description of this video. So you can go here, watch the video, or just follow the written instructions and change the database tables. Now, you can already see from here that this is not something that is easy to do. You'll have to change a lot of things, and there's a risk to your website getting corrupted or broken if you don't do everything correctly. So if this is not something you think you can do, I would not let you attempt it, or I would not recommend that you attempt it. Only do it if you think this is very easy to do and you understand what you're doing. All right, two features back to back that you need to disable your website to harden its security. The first one is disabling file indexing, and the second one is disabling XML RPC. Let me demonstrate what these are. So this is an example of what you see on the screen is a file indexing feature. Now, if anybody goes to your website, or at least the path of your website, and they access any kind of directories, usually this is what happens if this feature is not disabled. Now, you might think, what's the hard thing or what's the problem with this? Now, this is where hackers can find out outdated plugin versions, outdated files, less secure files, and then they'll find ways to hack your website. So this might not be enough, but this can give them the right tools and information to hack your site. So the first thing you should do is disable this feature so that this does not happen. The second feature is called XML RPC, and it's a programmatical way to connect with your website, and this bypasses a lot of security features we've been talking about, so you should disable both of them as well. Now, how to disable them? That's very easy. All you have to do is add a few pieces of code or a couple of code snippets to your htaccess file. Now, the first piece of code is you have to copy this called options-indexes, and all you have to do is just go to All In One SEO, which is a fantastic plugin. This will allow you to edit your htaccess file. So make sure the free plugin AIO SEO is installed on your website. And once you have that, inside All In One SEO, go to the tools section. Inside the tools, you have htaccess editor. All you have to do is just come here and paste this piece of code and you should be done. Just save your changes and everything is fine. The next feature that is disabling XML RPC also has to be done in a certain way. Let me show you what piece of code you need to copy and paste on your site. So to disable XML RPC requests, you have to copy this piece of code and add it to your htaccess file. Don't worry, I'll leave a link down to this blog post so you can find this specific piece of code and just copy paste it. I'm just going to demonstrate how to do this. I'll just copy it here. And again, once again, I'll go into AI SEO. Inside All In One SEO, I'll go to tools section, which has the htaccess editor. This is the piece of code that I entered just to disable the file indexing feature. Now all I'll do is just do this and save my changes. And once the changes are saved, both XML RPC and file indexing will be disabled on your website. The next feature you should implement on your website is an idle logout feature, which means that if users are idle for X amount of time, they'll automatically logged out. Now, think about this. If I'm working on my computer, logged into my site, I go away and grab a coffee. In the next 20 minutes, when I'm just having my cup of tea or not on my desk, somebody has access or can get access to my website directly and my computer. And when your team grows, more and more people will have access to your website. So the risk keeps growing as more people have access to your site. So the security feature you should implement is, hey, if somebody's not doing anything for, let's say, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, automatically log them out. And the feature is very easy to implement with this plugin called Inactive Logout. Just implement this feature, or I say just install it. It's a free plugin. And once the plugin is installed, you can choose the amount of time somebody has to be idle before they are logged out. It has a couple of exciting features, other features as well. For example, you can have a countdown of 10 seconds. So let's say somebody is just looking at the screen and thinking about something or reading something. They will see a warning that they're about to be logged out. So you can click away and then prevent that from happening. There's some other features as well, but overall it's a very useful plugin. Again, if you want to implement this feature, which will save your website and protect your website from unauthorized access just by accident by logging out users who are not doing anything. All right, so that's all the security tips I have for you today. Make sure to implement all of those and harden your website security. Did you like this video? Then let me know in the comments. Otherwise, you can just like, share, and subscribe and do all that good stuff before watching another video on the internet. My name is Yuvraj. You're watching WP Beginner, and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.